this week will be a week for miracles. Tell them this week will be a week for miracles. Tell them this week will be a week for miracles.
the center of my life. Oh God, Jesus, be the center of my life.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh, from beginning to the end, it will always be.
Yes, Lord.
It's always been you, Jesus.
Thank you. magnify your name.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Glorify your name.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God, you're the very apple of the tree. Yes, amen. Lord Jesus. What a mighty God we serve. Bless his holy name on today. Listen, I want to say that this is a great day to be alive. Yes. God has been good to us.
Yes.
Do I have any witnesses?
Yes.
Thank you. Yes. yes, yes.
Prepare the hearts now. That we might receive the Spirit of the living God is
yes.
in the church now. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen. Today I want to just kind of be up front and say that I have been going back and forth with this word over today. I finally settled with what the Lord had me to say. And I just want to talk to you today as your spiritual father concerning the season that we're in. Transparent this morning, and that's okay. But I want to start by saying this, what a season.
Yes.
Yes, yes, yes.
What a time. This one has been long, it's been challenging, it's been unpredictable, and it's been shifting to say the very least.
Yes.
In this season, I'm hearing a lot where marriages are being challenged, and it's almost like every single week I'm hearing of another person transition from whatever it is that they're transitioning
yes.
from. I'm hearing of health crises, I'm hearing of job loss, I'm seeing what's happening in our world, it's the unrest and the changing of the powers in our nation. It's threatening, and others are revealing their characters in this time. And so I'll say it again, what a season.
Yes, yes.
And to
yes.
be honest, saints, I've been trying to prepare another word because I wanted to share with you something else. I actually have it all prepared. I'm all set for it. But I felt as though that God would have me to deal with this same word that he gave me this week in our time together, in our life lesson sessions.
All right.
And that word is uncertainty.
Yes, yes.
Feel as though we're living in a time where we find ourselves facing moments when the next one is so uncertain. And the very thought of having uncertainty to be the very thing that runs through the thread of our lives, trying to persuade us to quit. The uncertainty is trying to persuade us to throw in the towel. And whenever there is uncertainty in our lives, can I be honest with you? Somebody say, yes, you can.
Yeah.
It just feels like the ground is going to come from above you at any given moment.
Yes, yes.
You're almost, it seems as if you're almost walking yeah. on eggshells, and you're always looking around trying to find out what's the next
yes.
negative thing.
Yes.
That, may I be honest
yes.
right here?
Yes.
What's the next negative thing that's going to come across
say
my
that.
Feet? What's the next negative thing that's going to wake me up at 1 o'clock in the morning and say, God, I cannot believe you?
Yes, that's right.
What's the next thing that when I'm in the very midst of praying for someone at 12 o'clock and by 12:30 their lives have already been taken?
Yes.
What's the very next thing that can cause you to be in a huge place of uncertainty?
Yeah.
But times like these, it's easy to fall into this pit of anxiety. It's easy to fall into this place to allowing what's around us to rule us.
Yeah.
Right. But I came today to declare a resounding resolve.
Yeah.
Somebody said, what's the resolve?
What's the resolve?
The resolve I want you to hear me say today is, I'm going to cling to the word of God. Somebody shall hold on to God's unchanging hand.
Hold on.
The Hebrew said it this way, time
Listen.
Is filled
yes.
with swift transitions.
Yes.
Naught on earth unmoved can stand. And this is where you shout right here. Build your hope
yes.
on things that are
yes.
eternal and hold to God's unchanging hand. Second verse says, trust in him.
Yes. Yes.
He will not leave
Say
you.
That.
Whatsoever the years may bring, if not forsaken, still more closely to him cling. Verse number 4 says, when this earthly journey
yes.
is completed, if to God you have been true, fair and bright,
yes.
your home and glory, your enraptured soul will view. And his chorus says, hold to his hand.
Yes, 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 yes.
God's So that's my resounding resolve. And we're walking through this time of uncertainty. I want you to rely on the Word of God. And the first word I want you to rely on is found in Jeremiah 29, verse number 11.
Yeah, yeah.
Where the Lord says, "For I know the plans that I have for you."
Yes.
And that ought to be a place that you ought to give him a shout right there, because if the Lord has the plan,
yes.
He got the right architect to
build
it. Somebody shout, hold to his hand.
Hold to his
hand. The second text I want to give you is found in Philippians chapter number 4, verses 6 and 7, where it says, "For don't be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving."
Yes.
Listen, don't you be anxious for nothing. You turn your anxiety into a praise.
Yeah.
God, I thank you that you are Jehovah Jireh, the God who will provide. God, I thank you that you are Jehovah Rapha, the God who will heal. Come on, lay your hands on your body and say, God, I thank you for healing my body.
Yeah,
he says it right here. He says it right here. "But let everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God, and the peace of God." Of God. Somebody said, "The peace of God."
The peace of God.
The other verse I gave you is Proverbs 3, 5, and 6, which is one of my favorite verses, chapters and books and verses in the Bible. It says, "Trust in the Lord."
Yes.
"With all your heart." Let's connect that with Jeremiah 29. If he knows that he has the plan, then trust in the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
He says, "With all of your heart, and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he shall." Somebody finish it for me. Direct your path. Direct your path.
Yeah, yeah.
The other verse I want you to look at is 1 Peter 5, verses 6 and 7. "Humble yourselves, therefore, under God's mighty hand, that he might lift you up."
All right, Bishop.
See, too many times we try to do the lifting, but the text teaches us to humble ourselves under his hand, that he might be lifted.
Yes.
Somebody say, "Humble yourself under his hand." And then the last one I want to give you is found in Philippians chapter number 4, verse number 4, where the writer says, "Rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say, rejoice."
Yes.
He was very emphatic about that. He says, "Trust in the Lord always, and again I say."
Yes.
See, if you didn't get it the first time, he says, let me just say it again. Trust in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord. How often? Always. And again I say. Listen, I don't care if you give a report from the doctor, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say,
yeah.
I don't care if your money ain't meeting together, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I say,
yeah.
I don't care if friends walk off and they need you, rejoice in the Lord always. And again I'll say,
rejoice.
Today I want to give you six practical postures that I want you to assume every day as you navigate through this uncertain season. Six practical postures that I want you to apply to your life as you navigate through uncertainty. Number one, y'all, I'm gonna give them to you, I'm gonna hit it, I'm gonna be done.
All right.
That's how I feel now, I'm gonna hit it, I'm gonna be done. Number one, as you live in seasons of uncertainty and you're clinging to the Word of God, the first posture I want you to assume is to forgive often.
Yes.
The first thing I want you to do as you're living in this season of uncertainty is to forgive often.
Yes.
The Bible declares in Colossians 3:13, here it is, "Make allowance for each other's faults." Y'all folk gonna mess up.
Yes, that's right.
They just gonna jack it up. They are. That we ain't gonna always get it right. You gonna jack it up.
That's right.
But the text says, "And forgive anyone who offends you."
That's right.
Make allowances for their faults and forgive anyone who offends you. Remember, the Lord forgave you.
Yes.
So you must forgive other people.
That's right.
Remember,
quickly.
Come on, come on.
Draw it to your mind quickly. The Lord forgave me when I jacked it up Wednesday.
Yes.
So his intention for me is to forgive other people when they jack it up on Friday.
Yeah.
Just as the Lord forgave me, I am to forgive other people, number two.
All right.
You want to pray continually.
Yes.
You want to pray continually. The Bible declares in Psalm 55, 17, morning, noon, and night, I will cry out in my distress, and this is what he shouted here, and the Lord hears my voice. See, it's good to know that the Lord knows your voice. It's good to know that the Lord knows your name. That means that you have been in constant communication with him, and my sheep will hear my voice. And not another will they follow. The Lord knows your voice. So when you cry out, he says, oh, that's Michael right there. He knows me by name, and so he says, that's Michael crying right here. That's Linda crying right here. That's Brenda crying right here. He knows my name. He
knows
my voice. So the psalmist says, morning, noon, and night, I cry out in my distress, and the Lord.
Yes.
He said, it's no matter what time of day you cry.
Yeah.
The Lord hears your voice. Number one, forgive often. Number two, pray continually. Number three, worship sincerely.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. Worship sincerely.
Yes.
Romans 12, 1 in the Amplified Version says it this way. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as living sacrifice. I want you to lift your hands right now, and I want you to declare and decree this. My body belongs to God.
My body belongs to God.
Everything I am belongs to God.
Yes!
So I said, therefore, brother, by the mercy of God, present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and well-pleasing to God, which is your rational act of worship. So you want to worship sincerely. Number one, you want to forgive often. Number two, pray continually. Number three, worship sincerely. Number four, here it is, remain confident.
Yes.
In seasons of uncertainty, it is easy to lose your confidence.
Yes.
In seasons of uncertainty, it is easy to lose your confidence. The Bible says in Philippians 1:6, be confident of this one thing.
Yes.
That he who began a good work in you, he began a good work in you. He began a good work in you. I remember when I was a little kid and I was sent to the principal's office for a fight. The first question they asked you was, who started?
Yes.
And whoever started was the one who got in trouble. You got to understand that you didn't start this.
Yes.
And it's not up to you to complete it. For the Bible says, be confident in this one thing, that he who began a good work in you, he will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus.
Yes.
And I want you all to let him complete it. Number one, I told you as a practical move that you got to forgive often.
Yes.
Pray continually.
Yes.
Worship sincerely.
Yes.
Remain confident. Mm-hmm. And number five, this is so key right here. Take advantage of every moment.
Yes, Bishop.
Because that's all you have is the current moment that you're in right now. You only have the moment that you're in. It was in sixth grade. Mr. Drake had us to learn this poem. I have only just a minute.
Yes,
only 60 seconds. Didn't seek it, didn't choose it, give a count of five reasons, but it's up to me to use it. I have only just a minute, but eternity is in. You only have the moment that you're in. We live moment by moment in this life. And so in this life, in seasons of uncertainty, live in that moment. But if you're living in a season of uncertainty, don't allow that moment to destroy what God has promised to you.
Yes.
So pray continually, worship sincerely, remain confident, take advantage of every moment. And my last point this morning is love hard.
Mm-hmm. That's right, Bishop.
Thank you, Lord.
Love hard. I don't care if they don't love you back.
That's right. Yes.
You are responsible for you.
Yeah.
The Bible says in John 13, 34 through 35, the voice translation, he says, so I give you a new command. Here it is.
Yeah.
Love each other. I love it how the voice says it. Deeply and fully.
All right.
See, we have that conditional love where, you know, I'm going to love you if you, you know, if you love me back and if you do me right. And that's all that conditional stuff.
Yes.
You know, get you back in the telephone, but yeah, okay, get back in the text mission. We love people because they do something for us. But the text says, a new command I give you, love each other deeply and fully. Here it is, even if they don't love you back.
Yeah.
Remember the ways that I have loved you. And y'all, God has loved us.
Yes, yes.
Woo!
Yeah.
Beyond some ways when we didn't even deserve to be loved.
Yes.
We didn't even deserve to even have him say, I love you. He loved us.
Yes.
In spite of us.
Yes.
So he says, love deeply and fully. Remember the ways that I have loved you. Here it is. And demonstrate your love for others in those same ways.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all, even when they turn their back on them.
That's right. That's right.
Love them.
That's right.
Even when they call you out of your name. Love them. Even when they start calling, this is real key for a lot of us. When they start talking about your mom, love them. So we have to love hard. Somebody say love hard. So I give you a new command, love each other deeply and fully. Remember the ways that I have loved you and demonstrate your love for others in the same way. Everyone will know you as my followers if you demonstrate your love. Other people. They're going to know who your father is.
Yes. Yes.
By the love that you pour.
Yes. Yes.
So I want you to forgive often.
Say that, Bishop.
Pray continually.
Yes.
Worship sincerely. Remain confident. Take advantage of every moment.
Mm-hmm.
And love real hard.
Yes. Yes.
Father, I pray
that.
This word that has gone forth in
yes,
this atmosphere
God.
On this morning, I pray that
thank
in Jesus' name, that as it reaches the hearts, the minds, and the lives of individuals, their lives are changed. And God, in this season of uncertainty,
yes,
I'm praying for everyone, everyone, that they will hold fast to your word. They will not let go, that they will not lose their hope, that they will not lose their grip, but they will hold fast to your word. Thank you this morning for being our God. And God, we're able to do it because we have you in our lives. Thank you, we glorify you, we magnify you. Heard the voice of the Lord. Instruct you to connect with us here at the New Tabernacle Church International. I want you to hear God, and not only just hear Him, but obey God. For it is extremely important in these days
yes.
to have a pastoral covering.
Yes.
Someone who's interceding for you, someone who's praying for you. Someone who can call your name out and ask the Lord Himself to be with you. It's important now that you have a covering.
Yes.
So I urge you, I beseech you
yes.
to connect. Make yourselves. He's calling your name today.
Yes.
He's calling your name today. Come into his arms. He's calling your name today. Come on.
Yes.
Hear the voice of the Lord and make the decision today that you're going to obey God. Make the decision now that you are going to obey God. Don't keep going the other way. Don't keep telling God, no, keep going. Take time today to give you an opportunity to hear the voice of God and obey Him. our yes. Make it regular middle this spring. And we'd love to have you as a part of the body of Christ here at Victory Tabernacle Church International. God is calling you. I hear it. Say that again. He's calling you to answer the call now. Yeah. Our vow would not be found uncovered. In this time, I would not be found uncovered. For he says, I'm sending pastors and leaders after my own heart. They're going to lead and they're going to guide you. Get courage and have the blessed assurance. Standing ready to receive you. Come. He's such a gentleman, he's gonna stand there and knock, but you gotta say, God, I confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord. I believe in my heart that God raised him from the dead. Come. Y'all, I feel it. I feel right here. Come on, come on. You've been going back and forth, vacillating, saying, should I not? Yes, you shall. Hear the voice of the Lord and obey him. Love to have you to connect with us here at the Tabernacle Church International. Well, we know victories in our praise. Father, I pray now for the individual that's deciding whether they should let you or they should not. Connect with the Spirit of Victory Tabernacle Church International. We give you praise now, we give you glory, and we give you honor.
Yes.
Satan, get your hands off.
Yes.
Stop talking in their ears.
Yes.
And I declare victory, they're going to obey God. In Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, give them a hand of praise.
Today's offering lessons, if you're in your homes, I promise you might want to get a pen and some paper and jot some notes. What God has given me this morning for the offering lesson has changed my whole way of thinking.
All right.
And what I've learned over the years is when you know better,
you do better.
And so I found out there are four biblical ways of giving. Christians should be generous with their time and treasure. Believers are to live above covetousness and greed. The first way of giving is our giving of alms. And giving alms is anything given to the poor. Money, food, clothing, shelter. When you see a need, you quietly fulfill it. Be especially careful when you're trying to be good. This is Matthew 6:1 says, be especially careful when you're trying to be good so that you don't make a performance out of it. It might be a good theater, but the God who made you won't be applauding. That's the first way, the giving of alms. The second way is our tithe.
Yes.
The tithe is 10% of your increase. The tithe is the law penned by Moses. The tithe belongs to God. If we really want to be specific, everything that we are and have belongs to God.
Yes.
But we get the privilege of returning our tithe to our home church.
Yes.
We are blessed or cursed is based on our obedience to returning the tithe. So don't fall in with the crowd who doesn't trust God enough to give the tithe. this lack of faith is a shame. God dares you to prove him. Put God first. He will bless your obedience. God will allow you to do more with the 90% than you can with the 100. The third way of giving is our seed offering. Anything given over and above the tithe, if you don't tithe, you cannot give an offering. So all you give goes to your fulfillment of the tithe. And seed offering is a free will gift. God commands that we give an offering. So we sow a seed above our tithes. This is where your blessing lies. Deuteronomy 16:10 says, celebrate the Feast of Weeks to God, your God, by bringing your free will seed offering. Give as generously as God has blessed you. But it's this fourth way of giving that blessed me so, and that's our grace giving. This is the goal of the Christian believer. Grace giving is when God supernaturally enables you to give beyond your power.
Yes, Lord.
It happens when God knows he can funnel money through you without you keeping it for yourself. The Macedonians in the Bible were able to give by grace in spite of being in deep poverty and great affliction. The average believer looks at their budget and tries to decide what they can afford to give. But the spiritual believer prays and asks God, God, what you want me to give today?
My God.
God wants us to learn that he can work through us mightily when we yield to him, when we give him the right of way. Tithing is the floor foundation, the least acceptable gift. But grace giving is the ceiling.
Jesus.
It is supernatural giving, empowered by God. There is no limit as to how much God could give through you if you would just surrender. And surrender means cease resisting. So this morning, as we get ready to say our confession, I want you to pay a tithe. That's 10% of your increase, because that's the least amount.
Yes.
And as you get ready to think about what that seed is going to be, that free will giving, don't just think about what's in your bank account. Ask God. Trust and believe he'll give you what it is. And if that number is more than your mind can handle, trust him anyway.
Yeah.
And give it. And watch him.
Watch him.
Watch him.
Watch him.
Do something miraculous.
Yes, Lord.
Not only in your life, but in your finances. Because he's able to do it. So let's get ready and do say our confession. Are we ready? A faith-teaching church, a favor-filled church, a praying church. We are victory, a family church, a caring church, a mission-minded church. We are victory, a tithing church, a seed-sowing church, a giving church. We are victory, favor, increase, blessing. For you to give it to victory. You can text to give your offering to 404-996-0076. 777. Or go to our website at www.igotthevictory.org. Click on that donate button and give that way. Or if you like, download our mobile app at Easy Time. All you have to do is look up Victory Tabernacle Church International and you're able to give on the Easy Time mobile app. Or if you just prefer to write a check, put it in the mail and mail it to Waterlake, Kellytown Road, McDonough, Georgia, 30252. Don't forget, get your seed in the ground.
What shall I give?
Yes.
And then he responded,
yes.
I heard the Lord say when Lady B was talking about that, and she says, when he tells you that you need to obey him, I heard the Lord say, I'm trying to get something to you.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm trying to get that from you. I'm trying to get something to you.
Yes.
And too often we pray and ask the Lord for things, and when he gives us instructions on how to get there, we start questioning the process.
Yeah.
Trust him, we sown our way through seasons.
Yes.
We saw our way through and our failure, and the Lord himself,
hallelujah,
is the one who provides for us. And so we thank him. And every time we sow a seed,
amen.
The Lord bless you. Listen, today has been a great day. We thank God for the wonderful things that he's doing in this season of uncertainty. I want you to do a couple things for me. We've had some major transitions in the body of Christ this week. And I want you to pray for the O'Neill family, and I want you to pray for the Pace family.
Yes.
That God of comfort would comfort them in this moment, in this hour, in this season of their lives. We thank God, and we want them to know that Victory Tabernacle Church is right here with them, praying for them, interceding on their behalf. Amen. As we bow our hearts to God and serve, we're grateful to God. Listen, this is going to be a great week.
Yes, it is.
And I want you to hear me say, whatever God does, it's going to be big.
It's going to be big.
Our walking expectation is going to be big. Listen, on tomorrow, we're going to be celebrating the holiday for Dr. King. And I want you all to pray for our nation. Pray for our land.
Yes.
Pray for our nation. Pray for us. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if my people will call by my name, y'all will taste of themselves. Pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways. From heaven, I will heal the land. So this is going to be a great week. If you just lift your hands and tell the Lord, thank you. This week, that is upon me. Listen, I want to release this word over your life. This is our year of restoration.
Yes.
And I want you to believe that God is restoring some things. Because the Lord himself has given us grace. He's given us the victory. There are some things he has also downloaded in us that in this year we're going to do a little bit different. The first thing I want to say to you is thank you so much for you all picking up your vessels, your elements. Last week we had our pickup for communion. And you may ask, well, why do we need the same one? Because I want us to have all of our elements when we are communing, and we're going to be communing together on Sunday. So thank you all so much for picking up your communion elements. Also be reminded that on the 31st of this month, That's the fifth Sunday in this month. We're going to do two things. We're going to be casting vision on that Sunday. And it's also our restoration in our community Sunday, where we're going to go into the community after service. We're going to get there about 12, and we're going to go feed, and we're going to feed, we're going to feed, we're going to feed. So our first outreach is restoration in our community on the third, on January 31st, which is our first outreach. Also, Lady B has a book club that she wants you to be a part of. Please go to our website, igotthevictory.org, and click on it, and you'll get all the information. Finally, listen, we have something for all of our couples on February 13th. February the 13th, we're going to have what we call the Two Become One dinner time together. We're going to have more information about that coming, but I'll give you a sneak peek on what we're going to do. We're going to have a session where we're going to be cooking together. We're going to send you your resource box. We'll tell you what you need, and we're going to be cooking together on February 13th. Listen, you do not want to miss what the Lord Himself is doing in the midst. Get on board. The train is moving. God bless you.
This week will be a week for miracles.